Monday Night Football. Things have worked out so far so good for 35-year-old head coach Mike Tomlin. In his rookie year, he has the Steelers at 5-2 atop the division. He's following a familiar blueprint in these parts. Run the ball pretty well, pass when appropriate, tenacious defense. Pittsburgh atop a division won last year by Baltimore. Baltimore was 13-3 last year. They've already lost three games, and their four wins, they haven't beaten anybody who's all that good, to be honest. Their good news, they get Steve McNair back after their veteran quarterback has missed the last couple of weeks. Joined up here in the booth by Tony Kornheiser and Ron Jaworski on a rainy night in Western Pennsylvania, and that fits the mood, because we always talk about the running backs, the quarterbacks, the offense. Forget it. If you love defense, you've come to a really good place tonight.
Mike, this matchup is not for the faint of heart. Whenever the Ravens and the Steelers get together, it's about smash mouth football. They might as well just meet at the 50-yard line and start swinging right now and see who is left standing. When you look at Rex Ryan, the defensive coordinator for the Ravens, he loves to wrench space in a quarterback's mind with ever-changing schemes to cause confusion. Last season against the Steelers, that Ravens defense had 14 sacks against Ben Roethlisberger, and seven times they had a clean shot at Big Ben himself. And then when you think about the Steelers and smash mouth football, it may have been invented right here in Pittsburgh in the 70s with the steel curtain defense, and a lot of them will be here tonight. But Dick LeBeau, the defense coordinator now, has taken this defense to another level. They blitz one out of every three snaps. Yes, it is the Blitzburg defense. And Mike, if you're Steve McNair or Ben Roethlisberger tonight, you better have your head on a swivel, because the blitz is coming.
You see the Steelers in their throwbacks. It's a game defined by defense. What an appropriate night, Tony, as they honor 75 seasons of Steeler football.
Absolutely. Look around this stadium tonight, and you will see the ghosts of Steelers past. Chuck Knoll's legendary steel curtain teams, who won four Super Bowls in 6 years. Bradshaw and Swan and Stallworth and Franco and many more. As the Steelers celebrate their 75th season, it's appropriate to note that the most honored dynasty of the Super Bowl era played right here in Pittsburgh. Not the Cowboys of Aikman, Irvin, and Emmett, who won three. Not the Redskins of Joe Gibbs the first time around, who won three with three different quarterbacks. Not the 49ers Bill Walsh built, who eventually won five with Montana and Young, both finding Jerry Rice whenever they had to. Not Shula's undefeated Dolphins, and not yet the Patriots of Belichick and Brady, who are at three and counting. No, it's the Steelers of Knoll and Bradshaw and Swan and Stallworth and Franco and Webster and Blunt and Lambert and Ham and Mean Joe Green. There's a Hall of Fame here tonight. This is the most celebrated of all the Super Bowl dynasties. Those tough men playing in this rough city of blue collars and steel mills, of lunch pails and hard hats. This is a city where football was born and meant to be played. And those are the men who gave life to that myth, and who even now stand tall against the Steel City skyline like giants in the earth.
As today's Steelers are introduced, a lot of yesterday's Steelers are here. We'll visit with them as the night goes on, as we set the table for Raven Steelers on Monday Night Football.
ESPN welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
I can still remember that cold night, under moonlight.
Get up, you lazy bum!
In the thick fog. We didn't like each other very much in the first place.
32 base, ready?
Break!
It's for the game, boys! We're gonna take them!
We didn't play to win.
Blue 21, set, ready!
We played to knock each other out.
Let's knock them down like 10 pins!
You gonna line up against me?
I can still feel the sting. Duke was our guy.
Did I hurt your feelings?
He had our back.
16. Set. Hit.
It's always been the same. It's either you hit or be hit.
Come on, boys! Keep pounding! Keep pounding!
That's why they call it Smash Mouth. Those are the games you remember. The ones worth playing.
And ones played in these parts for quite some time. Whether it was the old Cleveland Browns, which became the Baltimore Ravens, or the current ones. And it is appropriate that it is raining. We had so much rain, the players did get on the field for their early warm-ups. It's a wind-blown rain right now, and that wind might be more of a factor than the rain is as the night goes on, because this seems to be the back line of the showers. That's Reese Lloyd, who is going to kick off. Matt Stover is active. Lloyd likely to kick off tonight, and his kickoff rolling toward the sideline is finally picked up by Najee Davenport of the Steelers in their throwback uniforms. He takes it to the 31-yard line, and the game begins there. So here comes the Baltimore Ravens defense, and they are a big part of the story, as we alluded to before. Ray Lewis's crew is missing some of the guys who helped so much. Samari Roll, the 10th-year cornerback who's been to the Pro Bowl. He's been out with a spleen injury that has been bothering him for a couple of games now, missing his fourth game. And Chris McAllister, the 3-time Pro Bowler, is out with a right knee injury. So Derek Martin, Corey Ivey, start at the corners tonight.
The guy without his shirt is insane.
Yes, he is.
And he's out of here by halftime on a stretcher.
Ben Roethlisberger and the Steelers going into the wind. Willie Parker the carry. Gain of about 2. Ray Lewis right there to make the tackle.
The Ravens defense is very good against the run, only giving up 2.9 yards per attempt. That's the best in the National Football League going into the weekend.
Roethlisberger, the 11th overall pick in the draft in 2004, in his fourth year out of Miami of Ohio, has bounced back from a disappointing season in 06 with a good performance thus far. And the starch from the crowd has been taken out as some of the heaviest rain of the night comes in sheets from left to right as you watch.
And the Steelers go empty, surprising.
Roethlisberger pulls down, has room to run, throws instead to Hines Ward, completes the 46 to the first down gain of 15.
Why I say surprising, the rain is coming down in sheets right now, and with Ben with no one in the backfield, he's got to throw the football. You'll see him on a 3-step drop, trying to get the ball out of his hand, but quick pressure. Ben has been outstanding outside the pocket this season, outside the hash marks. 47 throws, 27 completions. Both those numbers are the most in the National Football League. So Ben likes to move and get out of the rush.
Officially marked at the 47, first down of the game. With Kerry Davis leading the way, it's Parker to the left. Matt Spaeth, the second tight end, could not get any leverage, and he's brought down by Terrell Suggs, the linebacker.
You saw the good numbers for Roethlisberger this year, 15 touchdowns, 6 interceptions, is all a 102.2 rating. There's a change at coach with the Steelers, and people say that's the biggest change. I say the biggest change is in karma. They had bad karma last year. This year's Falcons were last year's Steelers. It started with Roethlisberger's motorcycle accident, then his appendectomy, then his concussion. They got off to a 2-6 start. They're 5-2 now because he is physically right, and the karma is better for this team.
Second and 11, driving rain again, no backs, and they try the quick shot. It is caught by Hines Ward, but he's going to lose a yard and a half. Here's Ben to introduce us to the offense that tries to pick up third and 12.
All right, the guy that's got my back at left tackle, Marvell Smith. The leader of the line, left guard, Alan Faneca. At center, number 61, Sean Mahan. At right guard, from Auburn, Kendall Simmons. And the young buck of the line at right tackle, Willie Colon. And of course, everyone knows we got a bunch of other playmakers that hopefully make plays all night.
Notice the quarterback mentions only his offensive lineman each by name.
Smart guy.
Yes, he is. See what the Ravens do on third and 12. They bring five, and Roethlisberger throws down the middle and is incomplete. Nate Washington was the intended receiver deep down the field. Santonio Holmes also there. In this driving rain, it's going to be hard to complete anything. In case you were not watching on Monday Night Countdown, it started raining at about 5 o'clock. We had some thunderstorms, rare for November thunderstorms here in Pittsburgh. And at 7 o'clock, about 90 minutes before the game, when the players were about to come out on the field for early warm-ups, they cleared the field. Roethlisberger was out there. A lightning bolt hit, so they cleared the field then, and then finally took off the tarp that has been on the field the last few days. Rookie out of Baylor, two-time the Ray Guide Award winner, best punter in the nation in college, Daniel Sepulveda, with a bounce. Ed Reed lets it go, and that was a good decision. It's a touchback, so Baltimore will take over at the 20. The kick was 55, the net 35. Steve McNair returns under center for the Ravens after this.
Last season, no player was as durable or as valuable as Larry Johnson. On an NFL record 416 carries, LJ accounted for nearly half of the Chiefs' offense. His 1,789 rushing yards carried Kansas City into the playoffs and warranted a second trip to the Pro Bowl. After leading the league in rushing yards the last two seasons, expect even bigger numbers from the indestructible running back who has his eyes set on the record books. Greetings are different. Whatever we deny or embrace, for worse or for better, we belong. The need to feel welcome is the same. We belong together. You don't just stay here, you belong.
From the people who brought you.
ESPN's Monday Night Football is brought to you by Samsung, the official HD TV of the NFL. Hyundai, now there are more reasons than ever to check out a new Hyundai Azera. Dr. Pepper, with 23 flavors in every Dr. Pepper, there's more to it. And T. Rowe Price, providing investment management excellence for over 70 years. Invest with confidence.
Pittsburgh Steelers, 5 Super Bowl championships, so many of the greats on hand to be honored here tonight. Watch the Ravens and Steve McNair take over from the 20. And Willis McGahee runs into the middle of the pile for about a couple of yards. The rain not as hard right now, but still significant as McNair takes over. As Susie mentioned, second play of the first game of the season. The 34-year-old McNair coming up with a groin injury, and groin and back related problems to that core have kept him out of the last couple of games. Kyle Bowler in his place. Bowler's also had to relieve McNair a couple of times. So it has been a season of only 157 passes in the first 7 games for McNair. LaRon McClain, the fullback, with the carry, and McClain's only going to gain about a yard and a half. Jaws, one of the headlines for McNair returning is also the offensive line returns 3 significant parts that have been out the last week or so.
Mike, you're absolutely right. That has been the biggest problem for the Ravens offensively, the lack of continuity on the offensive line. Right now, they have their 5 best offensive linemen on the field. They feel that they will be able to stay in offense with this group.
Adam Terry, the tackle closest to you. You saw Jonathan Ogden, the left tackle. There's Terry, 78. Mike Flynn, the center, back in there. So they feel like that is going to be important tonight to sustain offense. 3rd and 6. The blitz is picked up by McClain. McNair gets out. stops and throws. It is ruled complete. What a grab by Quinn Sipniewski, who holds on to the 31, a first down. Gain of 7 for the second-year man out of Colorado.
An excellent job by Steve McNair, feeling the pressure, getting outside the pocket. One thing Steve can do is keep the play alive, extend the play. And once again, he's outside the hash. And so far this season outside the hash, he's completed 16 of 19. So when he gets outside, his eyes are downfield looking for a pass rather than the run.
Good job by Sipniewski, who's the starting tight end, as Todd Heap, the two-time Pro Bowler, essentially missing his fourth game of the season with recurring hamstring and knee problems. McNair over the middle, almost intercepted, in and out of the hands of Ike Taylor. How bad is it down there to Michelle Tafoya?
Well, it's bad. As you can see, obviously it's been raining. 75 minutes before kick, the tarp came off the field. I talked with Chris Ecton, the turf manager. He calls this turf USGA certified. It drains like a golf course. The difference between now and before the game, Mike, as you pointed out, it's no longer just raining. It is very, very dusty. The flags are blowing. If a kick has to be made down here, that's going to be a huge factor, Mike.
Down to the left, USGA, United States Golf Association. They have studied grass. They have the best possible drainage, but only so much you can do when it rains as hard as it did tonight. Swarmed under is McGahee by Troy Polamalu. Loss of 3.
Excellent job by Troy Polamalu diagnosing the play. The one thing he can do is read and react. You'll see number 43. Once he sees the handoff, he attacks, and he tackles low. He does not miss many tackles. But you'll see Troy Polamalu, number 43, showing up an awful lot tonight in the running game. He's a nosy player. Tony loves to get down near that line of scrimmage. And a muddy night like this, oh, he'll be dirty.
Best in the league.
Need to wash his hair 3 times. He'll be so dirty.
Third and 13, rush 5. Getting away for a second from Harrison. Now the ball comes out. It's still free. And you saw the arm reaching in, and Harrison underneath pulls it away. And the Steelers have recovered at the 20. Oh, now wait a minute. They pointed to the Ravens on the field. They made a mistake, pointing back to the Steelers. Pittsburgh ball. James Harrison's pressure caused it.
Turnovers, turnovers, turnovers. Here's Troy Polamalu. You see, he occupies Jonathan Ogden. That allows James Harrison to get free to the outside. The zone blitz scheme, he does an outstanding job. Dick LeBeau's scheme caused this turnover. McNair's got to put the football away in these conditions. You can't turn the rock over.
McNair has played 4 games to this point. That was his 5th fumble and his 5th fumble loss, Jaws. That you're a quarterback. You can't.
No, he's
lost that each one.
I agree. Most in the National Football League, 5 lost fumbles.
Jason Campbell, Washington, Phillip Rivers, San Diego have 4. Now McNair alone with 5. First down run, Willie Parker to the left. 3 to the 17. Terrell Suggs makes the tackle. Boy, that was the definition of putting a hat on the ball. As McNair was winding up to throw, Harrison's crown of his helmet right on the ball to give Pittsburgh a red zone opportunity out of the gate.
And Mike, you immediately see the impact of Troy Polamalu. He came on the blitz. He occupied Jonathan Ogden. You'll see it right here. Now all of a sudden, James Harrison, he gets free, and bam, you talk about, look at that, helmet on the ball. That's textbook coaching right there.
Hines Ward comes in motion toward you. Parker put the brakes on. It's going to be hard to cut and restart here tonight. Elote Nata made the stop, and Bart Scott, one of the linebackers, introduces us to the rest of the Ravens defense.
Welcome to Organized Chaos. Start with the men in the middle. We got Trevor Price, Buddy Lee, and Holovi Nata. On the outside linebackers, we got T Sizzle, Double J, AKA Larry the Cable Guy, and the GOAT, Ray Lewis. Patrolling the airways all night long, we got Ed Reed.
Bart's just coming out of his shell.
He's good.
They could be doing boxing down the road.
Third down, needing to get to the 10 for a first down. Show 1, and DeJuan Landry backs out. The Ravens bring 4. Roethlisberger not brought down by Price. Keeps it alive for a touchdown to Heath Miller. Flag is down. Price can't believe the one that got away. and Hockley's our referee.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense number 55. That 15-yard penalty will be enforced on the kickoff. Touchdown.
Price let one get away, and the 6'5" Roethlisberger kept it alive for a touch.
And he does an outstanding job here. Trevor Price thinks he has the sack right here. But watch, Ben. This is the body strength, the upper body strength, the leg strength. Now he gets out of the pocket. Now eyes downfield, looking for a receiver, makes an outstanding throw under duress and takes a wallop.
Remember, Price with the broken left wrist missed 6 weeks, and you could see that left arm not be able to get there and wrap around Roethlisberger, help Ben shake free for the touchdown, and now Jeff Reed on for the extra point.
This is what you see. Last year, Roethlisberger couldn't do that. Injured, concussions, appendectomy. Healthy this year, he makes that play.
Hey, owners, you know, you can get all your American sports fix daily right here on NASN, your channel for North American sports. Join me and this merry band of journalists as we
spit out all the sports of the day.
Why do you stop breaking matches at noon?
Exclusively
on NASN. Hort!
Cheerio, folks!
XGames.com is the year-round online destination for action sports from around the world. We've got the latest vids, bios, photo galleries, and news 24/7, 365. Moto, BMX, skate, rally, surf, and the exclusive home of the X Games. If it happened in the world of action sports, it'll be on xgames.com. Bookmark it and log on early and often. Anytime, anyplace, xgames.com.
The hard-hitting action of American football continues on NASN, home of the NFL. We head deeper into the second half of the season. The action has been ferocious, and NASN has another slate of top games. This Sunday, it's a live doubleheader when the Minnesota Vikings invade Green Bay to battle the Packers. And then the Dallas Cowboys face the New York Giants. Coverage begins with Sunday NFL Countdown, live this Sunday on NASN.
All the Steeler greats are up here in a suite over to our left, including Terry Bradshaw is going to join us here at halftime. See Micho Green, Rocky Blyer, et al. There's so many to name. They have voted on the 75th season of Steeler football and the best players in Steeler history, and many of them are here tonight, and they'll be introduced at halftime to this crowd. We'll hear from some of them as the night goes on.
And none of them wore these helmets, though. You can rest assured on that.
Yaman Figures, who's had trouble holding onto the ball, sees Reed be the beneficiary of the wind, and he sends it all the way to the end line. Well, defense and making plays. There was one made by Pittsburgh's James Harrison, not made by Baltimore's Trevor Price.
There is a land full of mysterious creatures and sirens of great beauty, where bands of men meet in fantastical arenas to do battle not only with each other, but with gravity itself, and fight for eternal glory. Coming to an NASN screen near you, the land of hoops and dreams, this November.
Halfway through the quarter, Ravens trailing 7-0, a turnover on their first possession leading to the Steeler touchdown to Keith Miller. And McNair's pass is complete to Mark Clayton to the 26-yard line. The importance of our game here tonight, obviously a division game, always so important. The Steelers trying to stay full length ahead of the surprising Cleveland Browns at 5-3. If Baltimore is able to win this road game tonight, we'll have a three-way tie atop the division. And certainly Cincinnati, one of the disappointments in the NFL this year at 2, and 6. Cincinnati lost yesterday in Buffalo, but glad to report Chad Johnson, who was taken off the field by a stretcher, showing no after effects from his neck injury. We wish Chad the best. They try to get movement on Jonathan Ogden, the left tackle, and the 10-time Pro Bowler will be flagged.
Ball start, offense, number 88. 5-yard penalty, it's second down.
And here's the offense that'll try to pick it up. Wide receiver Derek Mason, the introduction.
Hello, everyone in TV land, and introducing to you the offense for the Baltimore Ravens. At left tackle, Jonathan Ogden, the Jolly Green Giant. And at center, we got Mike Flynn, the guy's getting younger by the day. And underneath him, we got Steve Air McNair. And behind Steve, we got Willis McGahee, LaRon McClain. And at tight end, Big Sip, Quinn Sabnewski. And at wideout, Mark Clayton.
They go back to the ground, and McGahee gets only to the 24. We'll have third and 6 coming up. Larry Foote putting the stop on the former Buffalo Bill. Willis McGahee, who had 990 yards last year in Buffalo, a career low, unhappy with the contract, traded over here to the Ravens, and through 8 weeks in the NFL, coming into the game third, coming to the week third in yards rushing.
The Steelers, the number one blitzing team in the National Football League, 126 blitzes through 7 games. You could almost expect one here on this 3rd and 6.
You know it's coming, you just don't know who's coming.
They're coming.
They're all coming. Polamalu is almost there. McNair throws, incomplete. The pressure getting to McNair came from Brett Kiesel, who got past the center, Mike Flynn.
It's probably way too early in the game to say this, Jaws, but do you think the Steelers are playing like they remember what happened last year when they got beat 27-0 and 31-7 by Baltimore?
And you'll see the Steelers defense in what they call their sugar. In Buffalo, they call it the creep, Tony. And I didn't mean it was about you. In Buffalo, it was the creep. They call it the sugar here in Pittsburgh, where all those guys stand up on the line of scrimmage on the defense.
Sam Cook with the kick. Very nice. Pinning Allen Rawson to the sideline. 51-yard kick from the 25. Nice room for Rawson. Brought down at the 36 by Prescott Burgess, the young linebacker for the Ravens. We have a penalty marker down back near the spot of the kick, a few yards past the line of scrimmage. Nine plays, 9 yards thus far for Musa Smith and the rest of the Ravens offense.
They look bewildered.
During the punt, holding number 54, the receiving team. That 10-yard penalty will be enforced from where the kick was caught. Pittsburgh keeps the ball, first down.
Andre Frazier with the flag sits where it's caught, so it goes back inside the 20. Thus far, 9 plays and a whole bunch of hits on number 9.
There is a land full of mysterious creatures and sirens of great beauty, where bands of men meet in fantastical arenas to do battle not only with each other, but with gravity itself, and fight for eternal glory. Coming to an NASN screen near you, the land of hoops and dreams this November.
Coming over to talk with his veteran quarterback, Steve McNair. Remember, McNair missed the last 2 games with his injury, an off week last week, so McNair seeing the field for a first time in a month. Time the Steeler fans crammed in. We'll see their team have to go 85 yards. The penalty takes Ben Roethlisberger and the offense back to the 15. Lee Parker, a little bubble to run, gets about 3 to the 18-yard line. We know that Roethlisberger started out 13-0, best start by a rookie, the youngest quarterback to win a Super Bowl, although he only completed 9 passes in Super Bowl 40, the win over Seattle in Detroit. And then Tony talked about the bad karma, the problems last year. Where would Roethlisberger fit as a profile for a quarterback right now, Jaws? You know,
after spending some time with Ben on Saturday, the one thing I feel about him, he is very comfortable now within his own skin, within this offense, and with Bruce Arians, who's a defensive coordinator, putting this offense together. He is at a very strong comfort level right now.
2nd and 7. Ben sees No press coverage against Hines Ward. Throws to him. Well, third and two, Corey Ivey made the tackle. Come back to the first part of what you said. In his own skin. First, the leadership that you see out of Ben.
No question about it. He's become a leader on his football team. You said his fourth year. He now has matured as an NFL quarterback. The players in that offense look to him for leadership. From an on-field standpoint, I still believe Ben is outstanding in the play-action game. And if the first receiver comes open, I still don't believe he processes information quickly to get to his other options and stay with that progression. He likes to bolt out of the pocket, and why not? He's very good at it.
He'll do third and two out of the gun. Pressure comes from Bart Scott. Ben gets out of there and throws incomplete behind Nate Washington, but a flag down back by the pass rush.
Holding offense number 73. The penalty is declined. Brings up fourth down.
Right guard Kendall Simmons saw Bart Scott busting in, held him, and Pittsburgh will punt it away.
When you get in those third down situations against the Ravens, they like to attack your protection schemes. We've already heard it twice coming into this game. 14 sacks in the two games last year the Ravens had against Ben Roethlisberger. They're not always on the quarterback. They're against your protection schemes. Rex Ryan, the defensive coordinator, does a really good job of breaking down your protections.
Yaman Figures punt return for touchdown came against Arizona. We have a penalty marker down on a 49-yard punt and two fouls now as Figures is brought down up by the head at the 35-yard line by Quint Prewalt, the linebacker, and James Harrison. So we have multiple fouls on this play, and I don't think either of the calls was on Harrison.
Number 97 of the kicking team was illegally downfield before the kick. 5-yard penalty.
Mike, there are like five
correction,
flags.
There's another foul.
And Hockley, as he runs over to the other foul. Wait a minute. Yeah. I've got more.
Yeah, one more. We have an amusement park.
Have you been sitting on that line, Jones?
Yeah, I have been.
Okay, good.
I just want to wake Tony up.
I'm up.
You get it, Tony?
I get it.
Yeah, all right.
James Harrison was whistled for the, or Arnold Harrison was whistled for the first flag. James Harrison was the one on the hit, and Baltimore may have Pittsburgh re-kick this one. As Hockley sorts it out, there's the Harrison hit, and there was a flag down near the catch before that foul. And then we had two hats thrown by officials. So once you're out of flags, you throw your hat for a penalty. And these poor folks sitting in the rain.
It's pouring
it out.
Rain, the wind.
Let's move it. Let's go. Yeah. Tell us what's going on and let's go.
Well, the referee, Ed Hockley, goes over to Brian Billick to give him his options. I think reading Brian's lips, he said 15 more yards. So he's seeing the option.
Hockley doesn't want this game to go too long because he's got a date at the gym where he can do push-ups and sit-ups and get even bigger by midnight. So he wants to move the game.
Yeah, he's not real happy as to wear those long sleeves today. See, that's football right there. Look at this guy, man.
No, that's lunacy.
That's football, Tony. You're in a hotbed of football right here. This is where it started. Fans are into it.
There were fouls by both teams on the play. There was an ineligible downfield by the kicking team. There was also a personal foul during the kick. By rule, an option is to re-kick. Replay fourth down, and that's what the team has chosen. It's fourth down at the previous spot.
That was well done. Now I understand it.
So none of that happened. And we're back to Daniel Sepulveda, the rookie out of Baylor, kicking. And this time Ed Reed goes back. We saw Reed take a punt back 63 yards on opening night against Cincinnati. Sepulveda mishits this one, but the bounce works for him. Reed, great hands to scoop at the 32. Needs one more block to turn the corner. Ball out, flag down, Steelers have it. In the air, punt by Lawrence Timmons out of Florida State. I think that flag is a block in the back, and Reed having the ball pop up in the air on the contact by Andre Frazier is gonna lose it. And Harrison was there as well again. It was James Harrison.
It was James Harrison. Once again, the helmet right on the football. Clinical tackling. James Harrison.